Hello friends, can you imagine a life without electricity? Your answer would be no, as our lives are dependent on the electricity we get at home or offices. Imagine yourself in olden times when there was only limited electricity and all the tasks were done manually, like washing clothes, which now can be done easily with the help of a washing machine that uses electricity. Hi, myself Ankita and I welcome you to Unleash Science. Before we proceed, I request you to please subscribe our channel to stay tuned with such more interesting videos. What is electricity or electric current we are talking about? An electric current is a flow of electric charge in a circuit. But do you know electricity comes in two forms, alternating current and direct current? Both are essential to enable the functioning of our electronics. Now, what is the difference between the two and what they apply to? Both alternating current, that is AC, and direct current, that is DC, describe the types of current flow in a circuit. The electric charge in alternating current moves back and forth with the changing magnetic field. As a result, the voltage level also reverses along with the current. Alternating current is used to deliver power to houses, office, and commercial buildings, etc. This is the type of electricity you get from the wall sockets at a home. Direct current is a bit easier to understand than alternating current. Rather than oscillating back and forth, DC provides a constant current, which means the current flows in one direction only. This is a type of electricity found in batteries of your phone, torch, power banks, or anything operating on batteries. Now, you must be thinking, what is the need for two different power types? Although many of today's electronic devices prefer DC power because of its smooth flow and even voltage, we could not get by without AC. Both types of power are equally important. In fact, AC dominates the electricity market. All the power outlets bring power into the building in the form of AC, even where the current may need to be immediately converted into DC power. Usually, the powerhouse where electric current is generated is situated away from the city, and the generated current travels through the national grids by miles and miles of the wire. If the current is transmitted in the DC form, it will result in a huge loss of power, whereas if the power current is transmitted in AC form, power loss is relatively lower. This is because DC is not capable of traveling the same long distance from the power plants to the building AC can do. It is also a lot easier to generate AC than DC and is also cheaper to operate. DC primarily comes into the play when there is a device needs to store power in batteries for future use. Your smartphones, laptops, power banks, torches, anything dependent on battery relies on storing DC power. When batteries are charged from the main supply, AC is converted to DC and stored in the battery. Alternating current would work fine with a light bulb, but not so fine for your smartphone battery. For example, if you have ever charged your phone using a power bank, you are using a DC power supply. But if you are charging your phone using a wall socket, you are using an AC power supply converted to DC. Your phone charger acts like a power converter that converts AC to DC to charge the battery of your phone. I hope you like this video. Thank you for watching and don't forget to subscribe our channel.